有人怕自己太成熟，有人怕自己太天真，在成熟的年华保持天真，就是最美的人生。被人喜欢是运气，让喜欢的人满意要靠实力，运气就是让人看到你另一面的实力。大家都说瞬间易逝，永恒难求，其实全情投入的每一个瞬间就是永恒。10月25日，小米发布会，到时候见。
大家下午好，欢迎大家来参加今天的新品发布会。今天到现场的呢，有来自于五湖四海的米粉朋友们，你们在吗？有全球的新闻媒体，有始终支持小米的合作伙伴，还有北大体育馆的地主啊，北大的同学们，还有小米的老员工，你们在吗？谢谢大家啊，谢谢。同时感谢今天正在围观直播现场的朋友们，大家好。小米呢，从创办之初就坚持技术立业，始终在追求性能的极致、科技的极致。在过去这些年里面，做了大量大胆的探索，有不少突破性的进展。今天呢，我们简单回顾一下，看看过去一两年时间里面我们一些技术和工艺的突破是什么。我第一个要回顾的突破是什么呢？是在工艺黑科技上的突破。去年年初呢，我们发布了小米 Note， 全球率先使用了 3D 曲面玻璃。当这个产品发布以后呢，评价非常非常高。到今天为止啊，去年的话主要是平面玻璃，今天的话呢，手机行业普及了 2.5D 玻璃，但是像这样的 3D 的曲面玻璃呢，还非常非常少见。
And one important comment is this. A very important technology commentator from the US commented a Xiaomi Note like this. Well, I don't understand this English word, but he did say gorgeous. That word is quite complicated. I had to look into the dictionary to understand what he meant. Well, he said that Xiaomi Note is so gorgeous that it has met his expectations for smartphones. And that commentator is Dr. Wad Malsberg, the co-founder of FreeCode. So Xiaomi is one of the pioneers on 3D glass, one of the cutting edge technologies. And that was the technology that introduced our flagship Note phone. Last month, we launched 5S, and that is one of the few phones that used ultra-sensitive camera. So what is ultra-sensitive camera? The amount of light passed by each and single pixel is much larger, and it also provides much larger pixel size. Well, actually, you see that each pixel is 1.55 UM, which is much larger than iPhone 6 Plus 1.22 UM, and this is by far the phone with the largest photo sensor in the market. And because of that photo sensor, the pictures it takes are spectacular. And such ultra sensitive camera can offer great sharpness and resolution. And here you can take a look at photos, and this was shot during sunset. Last month, after 5S was launched, another black technology was introduced, and it's called portless ultrasonic fingerprint reading. So what are its benefits? Well, it can read your fingerprints through the glass. And because ultrasonics is used, it can precisely read 3D curves on your fingerprints, so it's more secure than the capacitive fingerprint reading technology. When we explore the frontiers of technology, this sentence often comes to me. This quote is from Karl Marx. He once said, "The path to science offers no smooth ride. Only the ones with perseverance can reach the peak of light." From the very start, Xiaomi has always been unswervingly exploring the frontiers of technology. We've launched new technologies one after another, and at today's product launch, we will show you more of our innovation. So, without further ado, what is the product we're going to launch today? You're right. The product you'll see and witness today is Xiaomi Note 2. Now, what is the biggest feature of it? Dual curves, two-sided curved display. And when you hear this term, many of you want to know what it is. It's actually quite simple. It is the front 3D glass with the back 3D glass. So it's curved 3D glass on both front and back. When we were preparing for the product launch, some of our Mi fans told me that you don't have to design, just copy the design of Mi Note 1. All you need to do is to add a fingerprint reading to Mi Note 1. But now, soon you'll see a much more beautiful Mi Note. And when the front is 3D curved glass, you can see the glass curve seamlessly connecting the left and right side. And more importantly, the screen can be extended to two sides, which offers a much wider view. Is it beautiful? See the natural extension from the front display to the sides. And on the back, it's also a curved 3D glass. And when light is reflected from the back, it's just spectacular. So this is the Note 2 that we are bringing to you today, the two-sided curved display. A seamless design is connecting the front and back 3D curved glass. When you see it, it's absolutely symmetrical. And the seamless design is very almost not noticeable. So that is the aesthetics we bring to you with the dual curves. And because of the symmetry, we decided to use 3D curved glass on both front and back. A famous architect once said, "Design must come from nature." The Mother Nature offers us the most beautiful and unique designs. And in nature, there are no straight lines. Straight lines is the work of human, and curves the work of God. And inspirations from the Mother Nature can bring us back to the nature. And that is the philosophy we adhere to when we designed Xiaomi Note 2. Note 2 offers the piano black color. and the color comes from the black glass. When you see the beautiful reflection from the black glass, it's just breathtaking. Apart from piano black, we designed a very special color for you. It's called glacier silver. Glacier silver. And in different light conditions, it reflects different colors. When light is strong, it feels like it shows the sky. And in dim light, it brings you the ocean, the color of the ocean. And that is glacier silver that we designed for you. Do you like it? When they're put together, it's quite a beautiful match, isn't it? When we put the phone together with the other items, you see how great they look together. They're real photos. Just breathtaking. They blend in with different types of items. I think the 2D pictures can't do justice to the Note 2. That's why we are showing a video where you can see the beauty of Note 2.
工艺和外观的视频来展现小米 Note 的美。
Flush of inspiration suddenly comes up to my mind. This is amazing, amazing moment of the flying lion, the shadow. The flight flow villains that inside and grow silently through my soul. Falling in love with you at first sight, cause I show you beauty, come a little to me. I will never forget the perfect feeling when I touch you. You are absolutely the question that I'm placing. You are the key to start my new world.
Can suffice to describe how beautiful Note 2 is after the product launch. Actually, we've already prepared an exhibition outside the stadium. You're all welcome to take a look at our Note 2. And actually, I would say that Note 2 is by far the best product we've made in the past 5 years. And that is largely because of the luster that the glass brings. And once again, please pay attention to the luster that the back reflects. Just let's watch the video once more. Pay attention to the luster.
所传导的这种美, 能不能再帮我再播一遍? 真的做得非常非常的漂亮。
A flush of inspiration suddenly comes up to my mind. This is amazing, amazing moment of the flying lion, the shadow. The flight flow villains that inside and grow silently through my soul. Falling in love with you at first sight, cause I show you beauty, come a little to me. I will never forget the perfect feeling when I touch you. You are absolutely the question that I'm placing. You are the key to start my new world.
So these two character designs like iceberg
things.
So how we made it? This is just like the iceberg theory. The iceberg is very splendid because only one eighth of the iceberg is on the surface.
So for these
two curves, what is the back? Actually, for the back 3D glass, is not that easy, but currently we can make it. But for the front 3D glass, it's very difficult to make. So this is a
picture.
The LCD glass, the glass substrate is glass. But most importantly, it has light guides. So for the current technologies, it's very difficult to make it into curve. If it's not curve, so it's very hard for it to fit into the 3D screen, and it will cause super large and thick bezel, black bezel. So if it's a very thick black bezel, people would not like it. So the front 3D curved glass, you need to use the OLED flexible display to make it happen. Because for OLED display, you can use flexible substrate and you don't need light guides. So for every point it can have light. So here we use the OLED flexible display. For such screen technology, it's a new technology in the past 2 years. So if you want to make a front 3D glass, you have to use the OLED flexible display. So let's look at what is the flexible display. It's not a glass substrate. You can bend it. So for the current technologies, the angle of the bending is limited. So for this 3D curved glass plus flexible display, we have encountered some difficulties. For example, low production, low yield, and very complicated process. So currently, we have the pressure in terms of mass production, and so it's very expensive. In this regard, it's super expensive. So for just one screen, it will cost $100 or more. So for the OLED flexible display, we might encounter some difficulties in the future. Now we use the 3D curved glass and the OLED flexible substrate. So there is a very big advantage is the screen to body ratio. It can reach 77.2% screen to body ratio. So for the same size of the smartphone, it can display more information on the screen. And the screen size is 5.7 inch. So some other phones are 5.5 inch. For the same size, the Mi Note 2 can reach 5.7 inch. So we use the 5.7 flexible display. This is the OLED technology. And also we have some innovations in terms of technologies in this regard. For example, the NTSC can reach 110%. And the contrast can reach 100,000 by one, and we have the reading model. So all those are the innovations for Xiaomi in the past 2 years.
So for this art piece, like the dual curves, one side is technology, one side is art. This shows our explorations for technologies. And speaking of this, I will now present one of my favorite actors. He is Tony Liang. He's an idol, and also he has great talent. So this year, we invited Tony Liang to be the spokesperson of Mi Note 2, and he showed the advertisement and the other videos, commercial videos for us. He's very handsome. So I just took a photo with Tony Liang. And all the colleagues, they all wanted to take a picture with Tony Liang. So my favorite movie of Tony Liang is One Generation Master. Why I like this movie? Because he has great talents. And he has great passion for film, and he's very devoted in shooting the films. And in order to make a great movie, he has practiced 3 years for the Yongchun boxing. And there is a sentence, a line in this film: if you keep practicing to your initial dream, and you will make it happen. So let's look at the video.
下面的话呢，我们再看一遍梁朝伟先生为小米 Note 2拍的广告片。
就像经典的冰山理论，一眼看到的美， 只是全部创作的1/8。美的一面，是因为另一面了不起的探索。艺术品般的曲面设计，背后是创新的柔性屏科技。Xiaomi Note 2双曲面，一面科技，一面艺术。
So, I believe now let's give the floor to Tony Liang. Let's give him a round of applause. Hello, Miss Lei. Hello, everyone. Is he handsome? Am I handsome? So standing beside Tony Liang, I look even handsome.
帅吗?
So I'm very thrilled to see Tony Liang. So we have this great opportunity to meet with Tony, and I have some questions for you. When we hold Note 2, invite you as the spokesperson, what are your feelings for this product? It's very cool, very cool. Thank you. Especially this dual curves design, I think is super cool, and it's very innovative. Because when I shoot this commercial, I hold this product always, and it feels very good when I hold it. It's very beautiful. And yesterday I got your product, so I didn't get a chance to take pictures with this phone. So I heard that you like skiing. I also like skiing, and you like to travel. So you used your mobile phones to take pictures, especially when I go to ski. So I just use one smartphone to take pictures. So if this phone has the video or image stabilization function, that would be very good. So do you have such function? Yeah, I will elaborate on this then. So I heard from my colleagues that
they said,
这个我们待会再说有没有放到，好吗？
So during the process of design, one thing impressed me is their iceberg theory.
So
how do you see this iceberg theory? Actually, I haven't done any research on the iceberg theory. So the iceberg is very chilly. So I like this theme, one side technology, one side art. I think art and technology can be combined together. So for Note 2, I see art and I see a lot of efforts. And the other side of Xiaomi is your consistent explorations for technology and your consistent innovations. So I will ask two questions on behalf of you. So before this,
okay,
I have done a little research
我就问了,
among our Mi fans. A lot of Mi fans, they are also your fans.
在这之前的话呢,
so I asked, what are your questions that you want to ask Tony Liang? The first question is a little gossip, because there is a very famous thing on the internet that you went to London just to feed the doves. Yeah, I was in Rome. Next time when I use Note 2, I will take pictures of me feeding the doves. Second question, for all your movies,
okay.
So in what movie do you think that will share the same features with your movies? Two movies that I can see that they share the same features with Note 2. One is The Grand Master, one is the Golden Time or Golden Years. Yeah, this will show one side is technology and one side is art. So the audience, they all want to take a picture with you, but it's very hard to realize it. So on behalf of all the audience, I will take a picture with Tony Liang. So you can just do some Photoshop and I'm just a model. So now let's take a photo together. Please, the photographer.
对吧？我就是当个模特而已，好吗？
So、we should hold a note to.
好，请摄影师来这边来。哦，哎呦，对，拿一个小米 Note， 对对对对。谢谢啊，
Thank、
这个摄影师。
So you should post these pictures on your microblog. So you can do some advertisement for me Note 2.
拍照的同学一定要发微博啊，主要是帮梁朝伟先生宣传啊。
OK。
也顺便帮我们宣传一下。好。
So is the Note 2 handsome? Is it cool?
好，中间大家看得见吗
？OK, left side。
我们的小米 Note 2帅吗？好，来我们这边。
So Note 2 is very cool, right?
我知道你们说的是小米 Note 2啊。
Don't joke, Tony Liang is so handsome.We have a lot of male fans of Tony Liang.
不要开这样的玩笑。
Okay.
梁先生这么帅，这看来有很多男粉丝啊。好，还有这一边啊，来我们。好。
Okay, this side as well. Please join me. 好 ，Here for some more photos.
还有这一边啊，来我们请梁先生再过来一趟啊。
好，第一点。
好，我们
Lower,
我们叫到这个角上、
okay.
来。好，好，低点。
好，谢谢啊，谢谢，梁先
生。Thank you, Tony. You're so charming. Many of them are your friends. Thank you.
谢谢啊，谢谢，梁先生。
Thank you very much, Mr. Long.
这个刚才呢, 梁先生呢给我们,
just now, Mr. Long joined me on the stage and showed you Meet Note 2. It's very beautiful. Let's look at the front. And look at the beautiful size, very thin. The back.
真的非常非常的漂亮, 我先给大家看一下正面。
Fantastic light, and it's very light itself as well. That is glacier silver, and you can see that the color changes in different lighting conditions. After Mr. Long left, now the stage is mine.
这个梁先生走了以后更好的耍酷啊。好。这个手机很漂亮。我是陪衬。你们叫什么呀？我吓一跳。
Why did you scream? Scared me.
真的非常非常的漂亮。
Indeed, very beautiful and very thin. The front and back are equipped with 3D curved glass, and a metal frame connects them seamlessly. The metal frame is very thin. We use series 7 aluminum for the metal frame. The phone is gorgeous. Look at the back. You can't see? Alright, the design is very simple. You can't see clearly? Alright. Later, you are all invited to the exhibition hall after the product launch is over. Would you like to see Lon once more? To watch his video clip once more? Alright. Let's view the video clip of Tony Lon once again. And here I would like to thank Tony Lon for endorsing in our product. Thank you, Tony.
Note 2 双曲面 一面科技，一面艺术。
Xiaomi Note 2 is as handsome. So Xiaomi Note 2 is positioned as a flagship phone for professionals, and it uses Snapdragon 821 SD CPU. Maybe not of you, all of you are experts in Snapdragon. Well, 821 is quite an upgraded version of the previous processor, and there are two upgrades, major upgrades. The first one was the same screen. It wants to be more power efficient. So for 5-inch small screen phones, this is very important because small screen phones consumes less battery and the duration is the challenge. So the Mi 5S as a small screen phone chooses the standard version of Snapdragon 821, but the performance edition, which is, offers better performance, is used in Mi Note 2 and Mi 5S Plus. These two upgrades of Snapdragon 821 meets different demands. And the highest specs is 6GB ROM with 128GB, and we use RPD 4. And we use RPD 2.0 flash storage. And this is the battery. 4070 mAh battery. It supports high capacity battery and quick charge 3.0. I'm not going to show you how long the phone will last after 5 minutes charge. That doesn't really mean anything. Well, Oppo is very successful in that advertisement. You know, everyone knows about the quick charge function, and more importantly, we support full NFC functionality. It supports bank card payments, as well as bus card. But it takes a while for bus cards to be fully compatible with the phones. I think it takes about a month for adjustments. And so please be patient after you get the Mi Note 2. Just wait about 1 month and a little bit more. It will support all bus cards. Also, it provides HD audio quality. It supports 192 KHz and 24-bit hi-fi sound quality. So sound quality is hi-fi standards. Also, it provides high-precision GPS with a built-in sensor-assisted positioning, or known as SAP. So what are the benefits of SAP? Everyone knows the pain spot of GPS, which is when we are in the tunnels, we hear from the GPS that it can't find signals. But with SAP, without actual satellite in the sky, you can get precise positioning. And signals are available even in tunnels. GPS is one of the most frequently used functions now. That's why SAP is added to our new flagship phone. So that is the specs of the Note 2 flagship phone, and they are the best performances and highest specs on the market. Well, Mr. Tony Long really loves camera. So here, here it is, 22.56 megapixel high resolution camera. Now cameras today are going two directions. First, resolution, high resolution, which provides more details. And the other direction is like Xiaomi 5S, which is about low light, color, or rather the quality. So these are the two directions. And Xiaomi 5S used ultra-sensitive camera, but here we use ultra-precision camera. The more pixels there are, more information will be recorded, and the resolution will also be higher. And here, an example. It's an original sized photograph. After you enlarge it four times, it sees still very clear. Actually, I can make it another four times larger because this is a 4K screen. Very, very detailed and clear. So when the resolution is high, you can have the maximum details. It is also equipped with stabilization technology, but not optical stabilization, but EIS, or known as electronic image stabilization. When you record 4K video, the stabilization is just wonderful. So what are the technologies behind it? It has a dedicated 3X gyroscope inside the camera. And let's take a look at how it works. And here you see a video with EIS enabled, and on the right is one without EIS. When you ski, when you walk, EIS will make your video the best version that it can be. Well, these were shot with Note 2 just a few days ago. So here you can see that Note 2 enables EIS technology. We asked some photographers for some camera snaps, and this was shot in Morocco.
A snapshot in Morocco
by the sea. A young guy at the sunset is walking along the shores, breathtaking. It's also taken in Morocco, a street view. There was a boutique selling art crafts, local artworks. These are colorful plates, and you can see the beautiful colors presented. A child walking on a blue street. When I saw the photo, I was in China. I wanted to go to Morocco and see it with my own eyes. Why streets could be blue? And here, a reddish-orange color. And the lady looks very cool. Well, I'm not sure it's a lady, actually. It was just stone taking on the street. Is it a lady or a gentleman? I don't know. Well, just he or she looks very trendy. So with me, Note2, we had innovations on selfie technology. The front camera is 8 megapixels. It doesn't sound very impressive. But there is one challenge, which is selfies sometimes are not very vague, are not very clear. It becomes vague when you enlarge it. But that is because there is no autofocus for selfies today. Selfies can only be clear when the phone is positioned at a certain distance. But this time, we added autofocus to the front camera. And now, whichever angle that you choose to take selfie, it looks just clear. As clear as it can be. And also, our selfies offer great details. Well, I tried it myself, and the selfies that the phone takes make me look much better. And we added an interesting function, which is called group selfie optimization. So when you take a group selfie, it will take several shots. And you see in the first photo, the guy's eyes are shut or closed. And so when it optimizes a group selfie, it chooses the best face and facial expression of everyone put it into one picture, and this is the final group selfie. Well, that's the pink spot of group selfie. Always there is someone whose eyes are closed, and I like closing my eyes and blink, and that function would work very well with me. And so that is the cameras of Mi Note2. The rear camera offers 22.56 megapixels. And when I talked to our engineer, I said, how about, you know, just write it, just put it 23 megapixels, you know, and the keynote speech. He said, well, there's a wall, we can't do that. And I said, well, our competitors do that. And he said, no, we can't really decide what our competitors do. And so when we designed the packages, I was thinking, oh, can we put 22.56 megapixels because there's not enough space? But our engineers are strongly against the idea of lying by saying we have 23 megapixels. In the end, we decided that we're going to be honest with 22.56 degree of megapixels. This is the phone with the biggest pixels on the market, and it is the only phone that supports autofocus for selfie for the front camera. Well, we just celebrated the National Day holiday.
So during your national holiday, what kind of functions of me you like most? Some people said I like the me roaming function most, because during the national holiday,
A lot of people, they went to the overseas countries for traveling, but for every day you can just pay 9.9 RMB and it's limitless traffic. Whether you are in Japan, you're in Hong Kong, you're in Europe or in Singapore, it's all 9.9 RMB per day. So you don't have to rent a Wi-Fi at the airport. You don't have to buy an SIM card in your destination. And me will give you a virtual SIM card in the air. And another SIM card of your mobile phone becomes a local card. So for this function, it will be much convenient for you to go abroad. So during the national holiday, I also see some complaints. They complained about another problem. When I go to the overseas countries, I cannot use the 4G service. So we have a lot of 4G bands globally. For the mobile phones in China, they support all the bands in China, but they would not support all the bands in some other countries. So this is another complaint. They are asking that, can you produce a mobile phone that will support the global LTE bands? Now we have launched this global LTE bands. We have six types and 37 bands globally. We just use this iPhone method. We call it six types and 37 bands. This is a global LTE bands. Here, these are the all global mainstream bands we support. For the gray ones, we haven't supported yet. For example, for some bands, very, very few people will use it. So, compared to the flagship mobile phones in China, for Mi Note 2, we have 37 bands. This is already the best level in the whole world. And for Huawei P9 Plus, it supports 32 bands, and Samsung Galaxy S7, 30 bands, and iPhone 7 Plus, 37 bands. So people may ask, all your mobile phones should support 37 bands, but it would cost a lot, and it will require a lot of technologies. So for this Note 2, we support 700 Mbps and high-speed 4G+. This is a new technology called 3 × CA. This is 3 bands CA. We can realize the CA communications on 3 bands, and the highest speed can reach 600 Mbps. So with the help of Mi Roaming and the global LTE bands, whether you are in China or you are in overseas countries, whether you are traveling or you are taking a business trip, you can feel free to surf the internet. You will never be worried about the traffic. So the price. What is the price of Note 2? This is a very good mobile phone. So we can take a look at all these features. So I don't want to elaborate. First, this is the best flagship mobile phone currently, with the strongest configuration. We have a 4GB RAM, and except for we have a 3D curved glass and a very expensive but flexible display. So the cost of the materials are very expensive already. So let's compare to other competitors, all their flagship mobile phones. They are very expensive too. But for Note 2, we want to produce a product that is not very expensive but has very good qualities. So the price is 2,799 RMB. So we have the two-sided dual curves and 3D flexible displays. I want to make it 1,999, but the cost is very expensive. So we have three types of prices. If it's 6GB plus 128GB, it's 3,299 RMB. And if it's a global edition, it's 3,499 RMB. So these are the three prices for the three kinds of products of Note 2. So let's take a look at the pictures of Note 2. Very beautiful. This is a piano black. We can see the glide is very smooth.
So this
appearance is very attractive. This is the best appearance we have ever got in the past 5 years. And also you may like this glass year silver edition. In about 2 and 3 weeks, it will be launched.
这个版本可能要稍微等一段时间，等两三周才能上市。
Take a look at the handsome picture of Tony Liang. When I invited Mr. Tony as the spokesperson, some netizens said, "So now Tony Liang is the spokesperson, I will not say anything bad about Xiaomi." And for Note 2 launch, this is the end. So I will show you again the video of Tony Liang. I will show you again the commercial video of Tony Liang. So after this commercial video, we have more products to be launched.
好，我们再播一遍广告片。广告片结束以后，我们还有更多的产品发布。
就像经典的冰山理论，一眼看到了美，只是全部创作的1%。美的一面，是因为另一面了不起的探索。艺术品般的曲面设计，背后是创新的柔性屏科技。Xiaomi Note 2双曲面，一面科技，一面艺术。
This is already launched product. Last year, we established the Xiaomi Exploration Lab, and we have a direction of this lab. It's called Mi VR Glass. This is a 2-edition VR glass. It only cost 49 RMB, and it was very popular. Just within 2 months, we sold about 400,000 units of Mi VR. This is the official edition of Mi VR. Let's take a look at it. This looks very high-end. So when you put this, it's very cool, and you can feel the sense of technology. And also, I just delete some pictures of female models, and they are so attractive. For this VR Mi VR glass, we have a hardware level motion sensor, and the sensitivity degree has been increased by 16 times. And also we use a series of technologies. Now we can reach this 16 milliseconds super low latency. This is the highest level in terms of mobile phone AVR, and it can reduce the sense of dissonance to the largest degree. This is the most important feature of Mi VR. So we know that it's not very easy or convenient for us to handle the VR glass, but now we have a 9-axis motion controller. It will support the touching operations. So we have this 9-axis motion controller. This is the interface of VR, MIUI VR. We have more than 500 panoramic videos, 3 plus VR applications, and more than 200 developers. They began to develop the apps on this platform. So what is the price for this beautiful VR glass? So the price is very reasonable. 199 RMB.
价格呢,
so this is the MIUI VR. So I will show you the actual
product.
So you can
wear
this glass, okay? Because my haircut is very handsome, I don't want to ruin it.
戴一下, 我就不戴了, 因为我这个头发很帅。
It will support Mi Note 2, Mi 5S, Mi 5S Plus, and Mi 5. This four types of Mi, Xiaomi mobile phones.
Xiaomi 5S, 5S Plus,
Xiaomi
Note
2. This is Xiaomi 4款手机. And we have a remote controller.
这个设计也非常的精致啊，制作非常的精致。 然后尤其是增加了一个遥控的手柄。
Okay, this side.
来。
This is the best quality of VR glass at this price range. So the VR technology is maturing gradually. So you can buy a VR glass to have a experience. Most of you might haven't experienced this yet, so we have a VR video to show you what are the feelings of VR glasses.
We have
reduced the cost of VR glasses, so I hope you can just buy one to try. Because many people, you haven't watched VR video yet, so we have now
we'll
show you a
VR
video.
And you can 平面的视频来展示一下 VR的感受啊， 也挺酷的啊。
many of you have experienced VR.
2 years ago, I played with VR for the very first time. I was shocked. And I think for VR technologies, probably the technologies will mature up in the next 3 to 5 years. But now, we've already achieved incredible things. And Xiaomi has been endlessly exploring the frontiers of innovation, and that's how we explore with black technologies. And now, let's take a look back at our history. Back, when did Steve Jobs launch the first iPhone? Well, on this date, January the 9th, 2007, which is about 10 years ago, he redefined smartphones with iPhone. And actually, in the following 10 years or so, all of the smartphones look like this. He gave a definition of smartphones, and all the phones started to look homogeneous, and that was the choice made by the time. But now, let's think about what the future 10 years will look like. But some told me that maybe we won't even use phones in the future. I don't think that's possible. I think in the next decade, phones still will be the most significant devices to us all. But what breakthrough will future phones make? Well, sometimes you see in futuristic movies that phone look like this. And future phones will be a transparent piece of glass, and contents will be shown on this kind of screen. But with current technologies, we can't go there yet. But in the future, the screen to body ratio will further increase, and screens will go bigger, and that's definitely the future trend. And that's the path Xiaomi is on. We are exploring the frontiers of innovation, and a while ago, a few years back, we started with our concept phone. And we've already made some achievements, and I would like to share with you what we have made. And so today, we are going to witness the Mi concept phone. Well, it's a piece of black glass, not transparent, because we can't make phones transparent now. So we made a black glass, a dark glass. It's just a piece of dark glass. Try to light the screen. Wake the screen. This is a definitely cutting-edge technology today. Let's try to look at it horizontally. It's a rectangular film. So. Horizontal, look at the screen to body ratio. Mi concept film. The first breakthrough that we made is edge-to-edge screen or edgeless screen. Just a screen, no edge. That's where we're heading to. In the first phase on this path, we already achieved 91.3% screen to body ratio. Definitely the highest screen to body ratio on this planet. And I think in the future, we are going to head towards 99.9% because 100% is impossible, and we want to increase screen to body ratio. And why is there a black bezel at the bottom? I'll tell you that later. So after we launched the edgeless screen with such a high screen to body ratio, let's now look at iPhones. 67.7% is the screen to body ratio of iPhone 7 Plus, but that is screen to body ratio belonging to the past. I think in the future, the screen to body ratio will be higher and higher. When you use a phone like this, you will have a strong feeling as if you have the world in your hand. Well, I tried to view some photos with Mi Concept phone. For example, the Oriental Tower in Shanghai. Isn't it gorgeous? It's like the world is in your hand. And this landmark building in Tokyo, Japan. This is the Imperial building in New York. The pictures are just so fantastic, and when I held the phone and watched these photos, I was just amazed. And after we had endless screen, well, the phone size is about the same with iPhone 7, and with this we enable the screen to be 6.4 inches. The phone is about the same size as iPhone 7 Plus, but the screen is 23% larger. Because the bezel on top and on the sides are removed, and the screen is made much larger. With a 6.4 inch display, the font could be much larger when you read, and more content can be shown. When you look at the map and use GPS, more details can be shown. And when you watch video, the video itself is much larger. That is the concept phone that we're launching here today. Well, concept phone doesn't really sound like a name, does it? Let's think. We started to think about a name for the concept phone. We wanted a cool name like this. Mix. Mi. Plus X. That represents our exploration in black technologies. So, Xiaomi Mix. And when we came up with names, someone suggested me that the concept phone should be more expensive. I was thinking about actually calling it Mi Expensive. And we're thinking about GUI. Well, GUI is the Chinese phonetics for expensive. Well, that was a joke. No. In the end, we decided to name it Xiaomi Mix, which represents our endless exploration in black technologies. And it took us a long time to make a video clip. And with this video clip, I hope you understand the philosophies and our ideas about this
phone.
We were 越不知道的，越想要答案；越害怕的，越想冒险；越不可思议的，越想去实现。用这样的好奇，我们不断打开身边的世界。 手中的不只是一块屏幕，而是通向未来世界的门。小米 Mix 全面屏概念手机。
So in the past 5 to 6 years, we've been endlessly exploring the frontiers of innovation. or known as black technologies, and that's no smooth ride. When you watch the video clip, it might not seem very challenging, but look, the differences between our concept phone and the regular phones on the market, because you don't see a bezel on the top, and there are no sides, and actually on our top we have a lot of things under this part of the screen. I'm not going to elaborate on that. When you look at Xiaomi Mix, the first thing you probably wonder is, where did the front camera and receiver go? Well, that is the receiver on the top, and we have the light sensor and proximity sensor also on the top, and the left port is front camera. That's on the regular phone, and many consumers don't understand what proximity sensor is for. Well, proximity sensor is very important to smartphones. When you talk on the phone, the system first needs to know that you're talking on the phone, and it will shut the screen automatically so that you don't accidentally press any buttons. So that is one of the functions of proximity sensor. And all the three functions are important. And the antenna is usually at the top of the phone as well, but when the top of the phone is a screen, it's a display. There is a metal plate under the screen, so antenna can't be embedded here. That's the technical challenges. So here, now let me answer your questions. Where did all these regular functions go? First, receivers. Without receivers, how do we talk on the phone? Will the mix be simply MP4? That's probably your first impression. It's an MP4. 3 years ago, we started to explore receiverless sound transmission technologies, and in the past 3 years, in the end, we decided to adopt this technology known as cantilever piezoelectric ceramics technology. Quite complicated, isn't it? Let me tell you how it works. Well, there is a drive unit, and it converts the electrical signals of the ceramics into mechanical energy. Do you know what mechanical energy is? Well, I actually have no idea what it is, but it vibrates, and the vibration will become electrical signals, and with cold vibration, the mechanical energy will be delivered to your ears. Does it sound complicated? When the technology matures up and the cost comes down, the receivers on the top of the screen can disappear. And for the entire smartphone industry, this technology is just priceless. And Xiaomi Mix is one of the frontiers in the market that adopted the receiverless sound transmission technology. And another feature, which is the proximity sensor, which is not big but important. Without proximity sensor, the problem is that the phone can't recognize whether or not you are speaking on the phone. Is the phone in your back or is it by your ear? That is usually done by the proximity sensor. So how do we do it now? Well, in the past, proximity sensors used infrared technology, but now we replace that with ultrasonic technology. So the ultrasonic waves are emitted from the back of the phone, and that's how the recognition is done. And when ultrasonic is emitted, it will measure the distance. The technology is simple, and it sounds visible, but to make it precise and accurate is the difficulty. And it took us about 2 years to bring this to our Xiaomi Mix. And Xiaomi Mix is one of the few frontier phones that has the built-in ultrasonic proximity sensor. And another feature, front camera. Where did that go? Well, actually, when we designed the phone, we actually wanted to go without frontier, without a front camera. Not a lot of people like selfies, right? For me, take me for example. I take at most 10 selfies every year. And then in the end, we decided to keep the front camera. Why? Because video calls are more and more common. So front camera is indispensable. And then we found a perfect location for the front camera. Right-handed bottom. Why here? Because, first of all, we have the PCB panel for the display here. And second, antenna. And loudspeakers. These things take space, and they are put in this bezel at the bottom. Well, since we can't remove the bezel at the bottom, how about putting the front camera there? In order for the front camera to fit, we have to shrink the original camera module. So we customized a front camera module that takes 50% less space. Look, 50% smaller.
So here, this is a dialog, right? So would it be weird or cool if you use such a camera to for a selfie? It might be not accustomed, but that some people try it, they feel it's all right. But some people feel not used to take picture with it, but you can rotate it, you can put it upside down to take pictures. So it's just okay. You can just rotate. You can just put it upside down. So we support the rotational
phone.
For the rounded corner, this is really a difficulty. So this is the
shape.
This is a rectangular,
rectangular shape.
So the right-angled displays don't sit well on rounded phone frames. We can see it will have a display border. You need to make sure there is a certain range of border. So the screen-to-body ratio will be
small.
And finally, we discussed with engineers. We just did one thing. We just cut the frame. We cut the corner. And this is a rounded corner. It's very cool. So here, the frame is thickened, and the screen-to-body ratio can be increased accordingly. So the rounded corner is not an easy thing. We have done a lot of work to make it happen. So people might ask, we need we have done it a rounded corner. So for the rounded corner, it would not display any information. So it will look more beautiful. For this points that we would not use, we just cut this several points, and we will get a very beautiful integration of the frame and the screen. So we have done a lot of work to make it happen. For the soft keys, in order to increase the screen-to-body ratio, we use soft keys, so it will save more area for the screen.
我们采用了虚拟按键，因为这样的话
，they have some disadvantages because they would account for the content of the screen. So if we put the soft keys on the screen, if it's a 16 by 9 screen, it will be reduced as 15 by 9. So according to this problem, we just add a new area, so to make it still look as 16 by 9, and we also have we also have the quick ball and its auto height. So these are all the innovations we have made. We have a lot of innovations, but I will not elaborate on all those technologies. It will be like a lecture. So for this edgeless screen, it's not an easy job. Speaking of the quality or the materials of the mobile phone body, earlier this year, in February, we used the 3D ceramic cover. So people say, I don't want the metal material, I want the ceramical material. So this gives me a lot of pressure. So for mix this concept phone, we used this complete ceramic body. This is complete ceramic body. We can have a look. This is a 2.5 ceramic back cover. And this is a ceramic frame. Also, we use the ceramic keys. So this entire body of the phone is ceramics. Because the material of ceramics is very good, it has very high quality. And it's very solid, and it has very good wearable property, and it will shine like pearls. The light of the ceramics are very beautiful. This is a modern technique and also a classical technique. But the cost of the ceramic materials are very high. So after I downed this is very expensive. So here, I want to show you how expensive it is. The most important, most difficult thing here is the frame, because the frame shape is not a regular shape. For about 100 samples, you can just choose several samples that can be used. So for one frame, ceramic frame, the cost is about 100 RMB. So it's very expensive. When we did the next concept phone, we do not consider about the mass production and the cost. We just want to incorporate the latest technology. So we do not consider about the cost. So a lot of Mi fans, they are asking for ceramic material, a ceramic body. I'm crying inside because the cost of the ceramic material is very expensive. Just one ceramic frame would cost 100 RMB. But technology is developing. Maybe several years later, the cost will be reduced, but currently it's very expensive. And also we have a detector. The second problem, because it's very solid, it's very hard. The frame and the cover is very difficult to connect the frame and the back cover. So we have done several work and maybe the designers, they suggest we can use the very traditional craftsmanship technique of China. It's called tenon joint design. So we tried this method. And we can realize the seamless connection between the cover and the frame. It's very beautiful. The screen to body ratio is 91.3% and 4.64 inch, and the complete ceramical body. This is like a scientific art piece.
So
all this will cost a lot, very high cost. So when we do the concept phones, we need very big determination.